What does love really mean anyway? I didn't want it to be this way, Drilla. I really didn't. Remember? You chose this.
No. Max, no. There's gotta be a better way.
A better way? The journey between this life and the next has many roads. This one just happens to be ours.
What? Our journey ends with you killing me? Why? Because I don't love you anymore? There's a million other women in the world better than me.
Kill you? No. Us. And they're not better than you. They're not better than us.
Us?
We have a past together. A history. A chemistry. A bond. A soul link.
You can build a past with anyone. You just have to give them a little time is all.
I gave you my time. I gave you my heart. I opened up to you. And you threw it away. You threw us away. Is that what soulmates do?
Soulmates? You believe that we're soulmates, Max?
Of course I do. I know it. I felt it. I know it. Surely, come on. You feel it. You feel it too, right?
I'm gonna live my life. I'm gonna fly away.
short dance, you're on your own. You're on your own. You're on your own.
Hey, I got dinner. What you reading?
Did you know the Earth is flat?
Huh?
Yeah. Apparently we live on a plane, not a planet. They just added a T at the end and everybody bought it.
Interesting. What are you talking about?
It's true. If the Earth was really 25,000 miles around like they say it is, then for every square mile there should be an 8-inch curve. And there's not. Research it for yourself.
What are you reading?
Just trying to expand my mind is all. Without the drugs this time.
Yeah, I see. So are you ready?
For what?
The poetry slam, remember? Don't tell me you forgot. You forgot, didn't you? Come on, Drilla. We've been planning this for weeks. Why do you think we're here in the city, in this dingy hotel room?
It's fine. I remembered. I'll just go put on some pants, brush my teeth, and we're good to go. I'm down with your poetry slam. Sorry, our poetry slam.
Okay, fine, good. But that's really not the point.
What's the point?
Life, Drilla, that's the point. You're supposed to be with me on these things. We're a team, remember? We're supposed to be living our life together.
Why, because everyone's just making shit up as they go?
Exactly. It's up to us to make our own paradigms, not someone or something else. We have to control our lives, live our lives, create something.
You're right, Max. You're always right.
And that's not enough for you, right? Everything has to have some kind of deep, poetic, philosophic answer, or it's just not enough for you.
I'm sorry that I think that meaning should be sought after. I'm sorry that I want more to life than poetry and beer and PhDs and sexual liberation and fashion styles.
Like what? Some esoteric quote that some old Russian dude spews out while drinking hot coffee in some existential cafe in the snowy mountains of Siberia?
To start.
Oh, Jesus, Drilla, you've really lost it. I think I liked you better when you were on the dope. Here you are, believing the Earth is flat and thinking the answers to life can be found in the pages of some dead Russian's novel. That's not life. That's escapism. That's romanticizing the world to be what you think it should be.
And what's wrong with that, Max? Huh? Like, I want more than some cheesy hipster slam poetry beating my ears dry and, well, people laugh at each other's stupid jokes, but only because they're drunk.
Then what is it? What is life, Drilla, huh? What do you think it is? Because for me, this is life! You and me arguing in this hotel room while some skeezy hipster is sweating bullets trying to memorize lines while he's worried about passing the mic check. That's life, Drilla. Like it or not, there is no existential cafe.
Fine.
Where are you going?
To take a shower.
The end is near! The end is near! The end is near! Can't you see that? The political media, the internet, and the phones have taken over the world, our minds and our souls. You're not who you think you are. You've mocked God. You've made costumes of the devil. You've paraded morals in front of the philosophical mud of the secular world. Justice is at hand. Jesus won't let you in at the last second. Redeem yourself before it's too late. Only you can stand before the judgment bar of God. Repent and redeem yourself. Only you can repent. The end is near. The end is near. The end is near. Here, take a flyer. Repent now. Repent now!
Excuse me.
Hi. Yes.
What exactly are you saying?
That the end of the world is near.
Yes, I know that, but what do you mean? Like, will it explode, or a nuclear war will erupt, or a meteor will hit us, or Jesus will return?
Yes, both. Maybe all. I'm not really sure. But can't you see that this is all getting way out of hand? We can't go on like this. The end is near. Repent or perish.
So how do I do that?
Do what?
How do I repent so I don't perish?
Well, you must be reborn into the light.
Reborn into the light, is that like a baptism or something?
Yes. First you must be baptized by water. And then you must be reborn with fire. The second baptism. The second birth. The cleansing of our souls.
So how do I do this?
What? I'm not sure what you mean.
I want to be reborn. I want to be saved.
What? Why?
Because I believe what you're saying is true.
You do?
Yes, I do. I've been dying inside for a while now. I've been looking for something to fill this hole that I have deep inside of me. I'm so sick and tired of giving away my money to con artist Christians and politicians who want my individual power. So what do I do?
I'm not really sure. No one's ever asked me that before.
They haven't?
No.
How long have you been doing this?
Let me think. Maybe a decade?
An entire decade?
Or two?
2 decades and nobody's ever asked you a serious question on your preaching?
No, not really. Not a single serious inquiry. Most people just mock me or laugh at me or ignore me. Those that don't want to be bothered by me, they just take my flyers and keep going. No one's ever really listened to me or joined me or smiled at me for that matter.
Well, I'm here. I'm listening. And I'm serious.
You are?
I am.
How serious?
As serious as that sign you're holding right there.
That's pretty serious then.
Yes, it is.
Why is that?
Because I believe the salvation of my soul is pretty damn important. Don't you think?
Saving souls is my business.
Okay, then preach away, Savior. I'm all ears, and my rotten soul needs saving.
Amen, sister. Amen to that.
Haven't I seen you in here before?
Probably not.
Why is that?
Because I don't drink.
You don't drink?
What the hell are you doing in here then?
Is there something I can help you with, mister?
Sorry. Father.
I just happened to notice you're a man of the cloth, and I thought I'd ask your advice on something.
There are better ways to introduce yourself, you know.
Oh, right, sorry about that. My girlfriend is always telling me the same thing. You're a smart guy, Max, but you really need to work on your people skills. My name's Max.
Sam.
No, Father Sam or anything like that?
Not anymore.
Since when?
Since today.
I see. You quit the ministry today?
Yeah, just now. I haven't had time to change.
I see. So, you decided just now that you're done with God.
About 5 minutes ago, before you walked through those doors and into my life.
Bad timing for me, then.
Yeah, sorry about that. I'm not going to be very helpful in the advice department today. Yesterday? Sure, but not today.
So what happened?
What do you mean?
Well, what made you quit the cloth?
I really don't want to get into it.
Suit yourself, I understand. These kinds of things take time.
So what did you want to ask me about?
I thought you were short on advice today.
I probably am, but since you asked, we might as well discuss it.
Well, it's my girlfriend, see? Druella.
Ah, woman problems.
I know. Can't live with them. Can't live without them.
Well, actually,
you can.
Let's grab a table.
I got.
Whoa, you look so real.
Because it is real, dummy.
You're not supposed to have that.
So what? I have it now.
I'm telling Mom. You're a terrorist.
Whatever. You kids are just too little to understand.
It's about time. I've been waiting forever.
Well, all we have is time, isn't it?
So we think.
White again. I'm always white.
That's because you always wear black.
Fair enough.
Your move.
Day 7, I think it is. I've been out here for almost a week now. I'm not even sure where I'm at. I skipped my journal entry yesterday. I definitely had some strange things going on. I believe I had an out-of-body experience, but I can't remember all the details. I know I feel a lot lighter today than previously, and I don't think it's just the fasting. I'm positive I'm becoming more at one with my spirit and surroundings. I have one more night left out here, and then I guess it's back to the real world. I'm really not looking forward to it. I've really, really loved it out here in the peace and quiet. I'm not knocking society at all, and I for one am totally down with all modern comforts, but I know there's something missing to it all, something we're shutting off, shutting down from making our lives richer and more complete. I'm damaged now. I can never return to who I was before. I'm just wondering why it took me so long to do this journey. All I can say for sure is, everyone needs to do this. Everyone needs to see the value of their own lives so that they can value the lives of others. If we don't, we might in fact be doomed. All I know is that I, for one, have taken it all for granted. The spoiled, rotten little girl that I am. I didn't know all I had until I let it go. Ugh, life. I am alive. I've never really felt it until now. I'm alive, and I hope more people can feel that way. Enough for now. One more night, then the trip home. Oh, P.S. I almost forgot. No sign of Fala Magula. I did have a bad dream the other night, but I don't think it was him. Maybe the legends were just that. Old stories. Oh well, just thought I'd let you know. It would have been interesting to actually run into such a creature. Jackie A, signing off until I get back home. Over and out.
The end is near! The end is near! You have to listen to the words coming out of my mouth.
Hey, kid, come here. Do you know what that is?
A ball.
No, you idiot. This is the Earth. The Earth in all its glory. And at any second, any day now, it could be gone. All of us. Hey, kid! That's my ball!
Come on, kid. The end is near. Especially for you!
Hey, well, it was nice talking to you, Sam. You really helped me sort a few things out.
My pleasure. I'm surprised I actually had any good things to say. You gotta go so soon? I might actually be able to cough up some helpful advice.
Yeah, I gotta pick up Druella. We're supposed to go to a poetry slam that some of our friends are hosting in the city tonight.
Poetry. I love poetry. To be or not to be. That is not a question.
Hey, here's an idea. Why don't you come along?
Me?
Yeah, sure, why not? It'll be fun.
I don't want to be a third wheel.
Oh, what third wheel? There'll be plenty of single people there. No, it'll be good to get you out and about. See the city and get some culture.
Maybe next time.
You sure?
Yeah, I'm sure.
Okay, well, you're the boss, Pope of Mope.
Have fun at your poetry slam, and good luck with Druella.
I will. Well, take it easy, Father. I mean, Sam. And thanks again.
So, if I understand you clearly, which I think I do, you're not a part of a coalition or church or activist group?
No.
So it's just you by yourself. And on the streets, all alone, preaching?
Uh-huh.
And you don't want any of my money?
No.
So, what do you do for money? I mean, where do you sleep?
Well, I work at Subway, and I do volunteer work at the shelter, so they let me sleep there.
Okay, I see. So, now what?
It's a good question. It's a very good question indeed. Well, Jesus says that we should do the work of our Father, even if we don't know what His intentions are.
He says that?
I think so. Well, here, hand out these flyers. While we figure this all out. Go on, get started.
The end is near.
Louder, with more conviction.
The end is near.
Better, go on.
The end is near.
That's the spirit.
Hey, this is kind of fun.
Repent. The end is near. The cold hand of God's heated vengeance is upon us.
Thank you.
Joella. Come on. Let me in. Let's talk about this. Joella, it's our night. It's our friends. It's life. Please don't do this to me. Come with me. It'll just be a couple of hours. It'll be fun. Joella? Joella? Open the door, Joella. Don't do this to me.
This is our life. We have one shot. It's just us. It's just you. It's just me, myself, and I. We can do this. I am I.
I can't believe you won. How many times have I told you?
Stay out of Grandpa's things.
I know.
Why would you bring a gun to school, Juan? You know how much trouble you'd be in? You're lucky you weren't expelled.
But Grandpa, I need it.
Tell me one good reason, Juan, why you feel the need to bring a gun to school, Juan. A gun!
I know what it is, Grandpa. It's a dangerous world out there these days, not like when you were growing up. Like just last week, my friend Billy got jumped by 3 seniors. They beat him to a pulp. I just want to feel safe out there, that's all.
I know times are tough, Juan. But guns are not the answer.
Then what is the answer?
You're grounded, Juan. That is the answer.
What? Why? No one knew and no one got hurt.
I'm not grounding you because of the gun. I'm grounding you because you went through my stuff again without permission. We'll talk about the gun issue later. Now go to your room.
Fine. Whatever.
Kids these days.
The end is right on our doorstep. The lion is... The end is near. It's coming shortly and there's no...
The end is near. It's a short time. There's not much time left. It's... Hey, the end is near.
I hope so.
It really is, people. I'm telling you. You've got no time left to fix things. It's all broken. Broken to pieces. Never to be put back together again.
It's all coming to a close. Shut down the stores. Shut down the television. Shut down the internet! The internet! The televisions! The telephones! They're listening! They're listening on your phones! They're listening on your toasters! They're in your refrigerators! They order your groceries! They know what you want! They know what you like! And there's no stopping them!
He came to take my eyes. I thought I was going blind in body and mind, until I learned it took going blind to see there was nothing ever real out there, just seas upon seas of my inner me.
She dreamed a dream of love and life and liberty, and sealed her soul to seven sisters of serpent fangs. She wanted to sail the seven seas, but wound up bearing seven sons to seven soldiers who ruled the world with swinging swords of serpent.
Truella, please, sweetheart, darling, I'm here, aren't I? I left the poetry slam early. It's not the same without you. Why are you doing this? We're supposed to be together. I want you back. I need you back. Well, I'll do anything for you. Why can't you see that? I love you.
Yeah, I know you do.
What? No, get in the truck! What was it, Juan? That damn gun? Did you bring it back to school again? Will you look at me when I'm talking to you?
No.
What did you do, Juan? What did you do?
Nothing.
Nothing, my ass. Juan, what did you do? You must have done something. What did you do?
Nothing. Drew a stupid picture, that's all.
You got suspended for drawing a damn picture? Let me see it. Let me see it. What is this?
Can't you tell? It's Muhammad.
Muhammad? Now I see!
I thought I was pretty good myself.
But you forgot one thing.
What?
It's my teeth!
Max, what are you doing here? Thought you were going to your poetry slam.
I was. I did. I left early.
What happened?
Druella.
You guys have a fight or something?
No, she didn't even come.
Ooh, I can see that'd be a problem.
Well, I thought it wouldn't. I thought I could go and have a good time on my own. See some friends, have some laughs, have some drinks. I wasn't having it. I just felt empty, stale.
I can understand that. I know you're not supposed to let other people control your happiness or your unhappiness.
But life is meant to be shared, to be enjoyed with other people.
Exactly! See, you get it. I'm not the only one.
I do get it, but finding good company can be difficult.
Damn right it is.
Want to know why I quit the ministry today?
Sure, if you want to share.
Matthew.
Who?
My mentor, Matthew. He died today.
Oh, jeez. I'm sorry.
Thanks. It's not that he died. I've seen people come and go my entire life. It's what he said to me that really shook me up.
What did he say?
It matters and it doesn't matter.
What does that mean?
I don't know. I've been thinking about it all day long.
And that made you quit the faith?
Not just that. I think it's just that I've come to realize something.
What is that?
That I can't control anything. That I can't do anything. That being good or bad couldn't stop Matthew from dying. That no matter what, we all die and leave the punishment or reward, good or bad, up to God after death just seems so hopeless. What good does any of that do here?
I see your point. But isn't living a good life here reward enough? I mean, you're a good guy. So that's the reward. You get to make friends and drink beer and laugh. And you're free of guilt and violence.
But that doesn't change the fact that somebody could come through that door and shoot this place up.
Well, nobody can stop that, not even God.
And that is what I have finally come to accept. So do you have the map?
Right here, like I always do. I don't know why you keep playing me, though. After 20 years, you've never beat me, and you never will.
I know. But a man's gotta try.
I guess he does. Although I don't know why you want this cursed thing. Some trails should be left unexplored.
Best to let sleeping dogs lie, right?
Right.
Check.
You're shitting me.
The end is near. The time is at hand when none of us will... You, my friend. Yes, you. You think that device is your friend. But it's your master.
My master? Why need this thing?
You're a slave to the device.
A slave?
And I bet you can't go a single day without using that device.
Well, I bet you I can go a single day without that phone. And I bet you another thing. I bet you can't go a whole day with getting one single convert with whatever it is you're preaching.
I bet you couldn't even pick up a stranger as a hitchhiker.
Well, I bet you I can pick up a stranger as a hitchhiker. You hold on to that. I'll be back later tonight to prove you wrong.
Oh, you'll be back, if there's time, which I doubt.
Drella, it's me. Max, remember? Drella, let me in. This is getting ridiculous.
Max?
Yes, it's me.
Max, I'm gonna let you in now.
Okay, great. It's about time.
But I have something to tell you.
And,
well, I'm scared.
Scared of what?
I'm scared of you, Max.
Me? Why?
I'm scared of what you'll do after I tell you what I have to tell you.
Let me in and we'll talk. I'll be calm. I promise.
Trella, baby, sweetheart. Let me in. Let's talk.
Drella?
Right to do this.
I don't know about you, but I'm pooped.
Me too.
It certainly was fun, Mary. You made this much more interesting and fun. And I think I actually handed out twice as many flyers as I usually do.
How many was that?
Two. Well, I gotta be going. You got a husband or kids waiting for you?
Yeah, I do. I did. I don't know.
Wait, whoa, hold on. What do you mean?
When I met you, I was on my way to an important business meeting, and I just got caught up with you, and I completely forgot about the time, and dinner, and the kids, and I just figure at this point, I just start a new life.
You did. New life, huh? Just like that.
Just like that.
So you said kids. How many?
Boy and girl, 13 and 10.
Oh boy. And a husband.
Yeah, almost married for 15 years now. Man, how time flies.
Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy.
What's the matter?
I just don't want to cause you any trouble. I gotta go. I'll see you around.
Wait, John. John, wait. I really had a great time with you today. You really helped me see the truth.
I did?
Yes, you did. I was even thinking about running away with you. With all the stuff that I have in my head. Start my life over again. Fresh, clean, and clear with a renewed conscience for God.
You were?
I was. I am.
Now, Mary, stop right there. Jesus is one thing, but home wrecking? That's another matter altogether.
I lied.
About what?
About why I quit the priesthood.
Well, what was it then?
This.
What is that?
Matthew gave me this. It's why I played him chess all those years. He said if I ever beat him, he'd give me this.
Well, what is that?
These are the secret directions to a man known as the dealer.
The dealer? What does he deal? What does he deal, Sam?
Well, from what I gather, many things. But this I got for a friend.
A friend, you say?
No, he's real. He's a real guy. His name is Hans.
Uh-huh. And what does he want with this dealer?
He wants to find another realm. He wants to find another reality. He wants to be changed.
Changed? Into what? And this dealer can do this for him?
That is the rumor. Yes.
So, you're going to give this to Hans?
That's what I said I was going to do. So, yes.
So, what are you gonna do about Druella?
Oh, the same thing you're gonna do about God.
What's that?
Well, I mean, God is gonna do what God is gonna do, and Druella is gonna do what Druella is gonna do. That's all.
Yeah, well, that's a little different, don't you think?
I suppose it is. I mean, I really love Druella. And without sounding like a nut job, I do think we're destined to be together.
How do you know?
I just do. It's in the heart. It's in the gut. You feel it. You just know.
Does she feel the same way?
Yes, she does. I mean, she hasn't said it in so many words, but I know she does. I just know she does.
I see. So what now?
Well, what do you mean?
Where do you and I go from here?
Well, I guess I'm going to go home and try to reconnect with Druella before she gets any more crazy ideas.
Like the world is flat.
Oh, exactly!
Maybe she's not so nuts.
Oh, get out of town. The Earth's not flat.
There are no edges to the Earth.
What do you mean by that?
I mean there are no edges to the Earth. From a picture, it looks like a globe or a sphere, but in reality, there are no edges. You can't find them.
Well, interesting. I've never thought of it like that.
Most people don't.
So Druella is right, then?
I'm not saying that. It's just maybe she's not as nuts as you think.
And maybe it matters more than you think that people can still call you father.
Maybe. Maybe so.
Well, good luck, Sam. I mean, father. Hopefully I'll see you again soon.
Me too, Max. Oh, and Max.
Yeah?
I never beat Matthew in chess.
So, where are you headed?
Home.
Home? Where's that?
Seattle.
Seattle? You're a long way from home, sister.
Yeah, I know.
So, what are you doing out here anyway? You hitchhiking across the country or something?
No, I'm not hitchhiking. I'm on a spirit quest.
A spirit quest? What the hell's that?
You ever heard of, like, a vision quest or vision journey?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, it's like that, only...
Only what? Come on!
Never mind.
No. You can't do that. Once you start something, you gotta finish it. You got me all curious.
Wait. Shouldn't we stop to pick her up?
Her? No. That was only for one hitchhiker.
What
bet? Nothing. You were saying about this, this spirit quest.
I really shouldn't be saying anything.
Why not? It's fun! Besides, I'm all into this new age, golden age, magical kind of stuff. It's all good.
You do?
Yeah, I love it. Guardian angels, fairies, magic, priests. Yeah, I love it. It's exciting.
Okay, well, this is really not what I'm talking about.
Oh, it's not?
No, it's not.
Oh, well then, enlighten me, sister. I'm all ears.
Have you ever heard of Fala Magula?
Fala la 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 what?
No, Fala Magula.
Oopsie whoopsie? No, I haven't. What the hell is that?
Well, legend has it that when a person is close to personal enlightenment, they'll see Fala Magula.
Interesting. And then what happens?
Well, when you see him, he has to see you back.
And what if he ignores you?
Well, Then you're on the right track, but you're not ready yet.
Let's see. Well, what if you see him and then he does look back?
Well, then that means you're ready for the next step of enlightenment.
Yeah, but what does that mean?
Well, you'll only know what that means when you reach it, but some say that you'll be able to transition out of life without having to die.
Oh, you mean like be translated like the prophet Elijah?
Yes, exactly.
Oh, I see. So you want to be like Elijah?
Well, if you know that, then why won't you let me take you back?
Because
what? What is it? Is it the money? Jarella, I've got money. You can have all of it. Just please take me back. I'll take care of you, baby. Just come home with me. I need you with me. You're my muse. You're all I have left. Without you, I'm nothing.
I know, Max. I know. That's why this is so sad. That's why I'm not coming home with you. And I'm not gonna take you back. You're a loser, Max. You're an out-of-date artist, thinking he's some sort of avant-garde, poetic beatnik, ready to unleash his intellectual genius onto the world so that everyone can bask in the glory of his original greatness.
Jarella, please don't.
Don't you get it, Max? You're not an artist. You're not a man. You're not even real.
What?
You're a fake, Max. You're a copy of a copy of assimilated essays and paintings and movies, books, television shows, government propaganda, religious dogma, and stagnating statistics of economic con men. Don't you get it, Max? You're trying to be something that you're not.
But I love you.
Yeah, well, I loved my dog, and he died. So what does love really mean anyway?
What does love really mean anyway?
Check.
You're shitting me.
Nice try, but I'm winning fair and square. Matthew! Help! Somebody help! Matthew! Help us! Somebody!
Hold on, Matthew. Help's coming.
Remember, Sam, it matters, and it doesn't matter.
Matthew! 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 No, God, why?
Now, Mary, stop right there. Jesus is one thing, but home wrecking? That's another matter altogether. Mary, no. Come on, what's the point of doing one right thing if it just wrongs another? That's all I'm trying to say.
If the right is greater than the wrong, it makes all the difference in the world, don't you think?
That is sound logic right there. I can't argue with that.
So now what?
Now what? What now, she says. I don't know. I've never done this before.
So what do you usually do when you're done preaching, when you're alone?
Normally, I go to Subway and wash up for a shift.
Okay, then that's what we're doing.
We are.
Mm-hmm.
We are, then.
So what do you usually get?
What do you mean?
Your sandwich at Subway, what do you usually get?
Ham on rye?
Ham on rye. I like the sound of that.
Found the gun. You're in deep shit, mister. Quit going through my things. Come home now. You're grounded again. Love, Gramps.
Oh, shit.
So, tell me more about this Balamagula.
Well, legend has it that he comes and watches you in the night to learn your deepest, darkest secrets.
Creepy, man!
Balamagula is said to be made up of many different souls. Souls that couldn't make it on their own, so they melded together to make one large soul. It is said that Balamagula can take on any form, but is mainly known for looking like a blob or a shadow or black smoke or ink. When someone begins their spiritual journey, they will begin to see moving shadows from the corner of their eye. They will begin to hear voices, whispers of the other world, and will begin to have dreams of the astral plane. Some have been known to go mad, insane, and some have even committed suicide. It is said that when you see Fala Magula, it is a sign of the mystic, saint, or visionary. It is a very good sign, unless you're not ready or committed. If you're not, the darkness begins to descend. If you're ready, then the translated process begins.
Interesting. I don't think I'm ready for a quest like that. You sure you are?
Yes. Yes, I am. I've been ready and looking for almost a year now.
You have? You see him yet? Well, keep your chin up, sister. I'm sure it'll happen for you.
I have seen some dark shadows out of the corner of my eye from time to time.
Well, see, there you go! You're on your way, kid.
Thanks. Looks like this is my stop, actually.
Are you sure?
Well, you going to Seattle?
No, I guess not. Thanks, Jackie. I hope you find what you're looking for.
Hey, no, thanks. And thanks for the ride, Roman.
My pleasure. Besides, I haven't lost a bet yet.
All right, you never actually told me about that bet. What's up with that?
Looks like a story for another time. It looks like your friend's here to pick you up.
Wait, what? My friend? No one's picking me up.
Anything to say for your first slate, Dan?
All right, Ciro, Spero, scene two, take one.
Yay.
Good job.
It's like hard to get the gum positioned so I can blow a bubble and not screw it up.
Old Russian wrote down in a book while drinking hot coffee. I know. Old Russian. Spews. I want to get spews in there. Some old Russian spews out over a cup of hot local coffee. Okay.
You're a man. Pork frog. If you take that shortcut, you're on your own.
Man. Yeah, sorry about that. I'm not.
Action. Tell me, Juan, why would you bring a school? Yeah, bring a school?
Boys.
Oh my god! I can't make that up there, Pip.
Okay.
It's like so steep and deep.
You're a man in a trance. If you take that short dance.
And of course, look at this truck.
Is near. Can't you all see that?
Are we rolling?
Oh, okay. So it's just this stuff.
Whatever. You kids just don't get it anyways.
Action.
Not supposed to have that.
Action.
You're a terrorist.
How near is it?
We don't know. See, that's the thing that the Bible says. No people know.
The time is
coming.
Yeah. Not even the angels in heaven, but my Father only. Okay, ready?
Picture? A stupid picture and you got suspended for that? Let me see it!
White again. I'm always white.
You're a man in a trance. If you take that
Let's.
Oh. Oh yeah, you were leaning against it. So.
My first mouth shut.
Sitting on a back porch on a Sunday afternoon, tripping on some whiskey that you hope will come down soon. I don't know, you don't know. We're all drinking with a woman, gonna make you go insane, make you wanna stick a bullet straight into your brain.
Thank you.